Let's do a quick recap of what we have done so far. We started with the question, can we identify people based on their location patterns? Then we decided to use linear methods to do classification. We wanted to use a Euclidean distance measured over different times of the day as our features. We cleaned the data, we selected the features, and we made sure we have enough data to build our model. Let's come back to the question of using the Euclidean distance. First, let's define what this distance is. The Euclidean distance is the distance we can measure between two points. Let's say these two points are point 1, given by the coordinates x1 and y1, and a point 2, given by the coordinates x2 and y2. Our goal is to measure the distance of the line joining point 1 and point 2. This distance between point 1 and point 2 can be written as the square root of the sum of the squares of the difference of the coordinates. So in this case, it's x1 minus x2 squared plus y1 minus y2 squared. In the data, we started with x and y coordinates. From the x and y coordinates, we made a transformation to calculate a distance between the x and y coordinates for each position at a given time and some arbitrary origin point, which we denote here as 0, 0. Notice we took two variables, x and y, and transformed it into one variable, which was the distance function. We did not necessarily have to do this. We could have used x and y independently as features and still done the analysis. On the other hand, we could have also used a different distance function. In the next video, we will investigate using a different distance function. But before we do so, let's get back to our IPython notebooks, calculate these distances to be used as our features in our model. Getting back to the IPython notebook, here we have the code that calculates the Euclidean distance between the two points. We do this for all the points in our dataset. Running this part of the code sets the distance metric to be our Euclidean distance. This is what we will use for the classification problem. In the next part of the code, we'll calculate each person's distance from the origin at 4, 5, 6, and 7 p.m. every day. These are the four different hours we have chosen to get our locations. The people or the driver ID will be our class's Y. We will use the values of X to learn values of Y. In the function here, we are filling out two arrays of X and Y. In X, we append the distances, and in Y, we append the person IDs. The method in the end returns us two arrays of X and Y. After running the above code, we now want to check what the data holds for each of the persons. Running this part of the code should result in a list of the persons and the number of events we are left with for each of these persons. So after running this, we now have a list of the name of the person with the number of events. The number of data points or events have reduced significantly because we have chosen to use only four different times of day when we collect the location information. We do not use the data from the other times.